vida de sus hijos. Amén. I know we have been teaching on the altar, but God laid this in my heart. Would it be okay if we just push that other series just a little bit back so that I can give you what I need to give you today? Because I believe some of you need this. Algunos de ustedes necesitan esta palabra hoy. Come on. But I need your help. Necesito su ayuda. Right off the back, it's going to be very challenging. And I'm going to get in your stuff. Is that okay?
Amen.
Va a ser muy retador esta palabra. Me voy a meter en sus negocios. ¿Está bien? Like when I stand out there, you're going to say, Pastor, did you have a camera in my house or somewhere? Like, that's how I'm going to get in there. Because I believe that in order to help this nation, we got to be healed. Para ayudar a esta nación, nosotros tenemos que... Listen, you can't look to government for help. You got to look to Jesus. Come on, somebody. El gobierno no te puede ayudar, pero que te puede ayudar se llama Jesús. So, the book that I'm going to talk to you about, en el libro del cual te voy a hablar esta palabra, is a book that a lot of, mostly men, love this book, called the Book of Proverbs. El libro de los Proverbios. It's a book of wisdom. Trae mucha sabiduría. It's got a lot of wisdom in it. And I don't think I'm going to go deep, but I think it's going to be very helpful to you. If you are taking notes, I would encourage you to take notes on your cell phone, on your iPad, on whatever you have, smartphone, dumb phone, whatever you have, amen? Teléfono, lo que sea. Toma notas. Because I believe, I preached this message a while back, way back, and the Lord brought this back up last night into my life, into my remembrance, amen? Prediqué este mensaje hace mucho tiempo, el Señor me lo trajo a la memoria. And I want to be able to give it to you today. Amen? If you're taking notes. What I want to do real quick, I want you to I want you to check in right now. I know a lot of you have Facebook, so check in and say, I'm at VCC today. And I'm about to receive God's word. Voy a recibir la palabra de Dios. So I'm going to check in right now. Hallelujah. Some of you selfie people, you can take a selfie real quick and just say, make sure that they let you, because you can put your VCC and you might be at Walmart, amen, or somewhere else, but let's do that real quick, amen. We want to welcome you. We want to welcome everybody that is watching online, todos los que están viendo en línea, aleluya, que Dios me los bendiga, aleluya, Perú, Colombia, los hermanos, aleluya, que nos ve todos los domingos, the people that see us every Sunday, we welcome them as well online, aleluya. Dele gloria a Dios. Are you ready? Are you, y'all don't look like y'all ready. Are y'all ready?
Ready?
Let me pray for you real quick. Father, I pray that they don't get mad as they deliver this word. I pray that you deal with their heart. In the mighty name of Jesus, lidia con el corazón, Señor, que no se enoje con esta palabra. I just want to release this word that I believe will be a blessing to their life like it's been to my life. Que sea Señor de bendición para su vida como lo ha hecho para mí. We thank you for a powerful first part of the service. For the deliverance. Gracias por la liberación de la primera parte del servicio. We thank you, God. But we also thank you for the word. Because the word works. La palabra trabaja. And my prayer today, God, is that we don't only have hearers of your word, but also doers of the word. Que no solamente tengamos oidores de tu palabra, sino que tengamos hacedores de tu palabra. In the mighty name of Jesus. So, Father, he that has an ear, let him hear what the Spirit will speak this morning. Que aquel que tenga oídos, que escuche lo que el Espíritu va a hablar en el nombre de Jesús. And all of God's people said, amen and amen. The book of Proverbs was written by Solomon. El libro de Proverbios fue escrito por Salomón. Solomon was the wisest man that ever lived. But also the wealthiest man that ever lived. Salomón fue el hombre más sabio que existía o que ha existido, pero también era el hombre más bendecido que había o que ha visto en la historia. Amén. And I want to let you know that wisdom will always bring wealth. You say that again, because I told you I need your help and you're not helping. Wisdom will always bring wealth. La sabiduría, hermano, siempre nos va a traer, aleluya, esas riquezas. Right off the bat, write this down. Escribe esto. Success is intentional, not accidental. El éxito es intencional, no es un accidente. Nobody runs the marathon and slips into the finish line and says, "Oh, I was just sitting down over there minding my own business and I just slipped and fell and I landed on the finish line." No. Success is intentional. El éxito es intencional.
That's right.
Are you here with me?
Amen.
If people have won the marathon, it's because they have been training for a long time. Si alguien ha ganado el maratón, mi hermano, puede ser porque han estado, aleluya, entrenando por mucho tiempo.
Amen.
Are you here with me?
Yes.
Therefore, they are not surprised when they win the marathon. Because that's what they've been training for.
Amen.
Are you here with me?
Amen.
See, some of us get surprised when something happens that we have been praying for. ¿Cuántos de ustedes se sorprenden cuando Dios hace lo que ustedes están orando?
Amen.
That tells me that you were not really trusting God that he could do it. And if he did it, wow, God really did it.
Amen.
Are you here with me? I never thought God could do that for me. You nunca pensaba, well, you prayed about it. Usted oraba por eso. So if you train for something and you train not to lose, you always train to win. Entrenamos para algo. Entrenamos, mi hermano, para ganar, no para perder. So it should, look at your neighbor and tell him, it should catch you by surprise when you win. I plan on winning. Come on, somebody. I plan on winning. Every time I used to play soccer, every time I got on the field, my mind was on winning. Even though I lost, aun cuando perdía, my mind, it didn't change my mind. I still got up the next Sunday and went in there believing that I was going to win. Creyendo que iba a ganar.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Are you here with me?
Hallelujah.
So when we seek the kingdom of God, will automatically have success.
Amen.
You seek the kingdom of God, and God will bring the things that you're seeking. The Bible says, seek you first the what? Busca primeramente el reino de Dios y su justicia. Y las cosas. Things will be added on to you. The right people will be added on to you. La gente correcta será añadida a tu vida. Are you here with me? But if you don't seek the kingdom of God, you'll attract the wrong people. Let's let that one float a little bit longer out there. Si no buscamos el reino de Dios, la gente incorrecta va a venir a nuestra vida. Why am I always attracting this kind of people? ¿Por qué estoy siempre atrayendo esta clase de gente? Are you here with me? God is good. The wrong people will ruin your life. La gente incorrecta, mi hermano, va a arruinar tu vida. But those of you who seek God, God will make sure that the right ones come your way. Pero aquellos que buscamos de Dios, mi hermano, Dios se va a encargar, aleluya, de traer la gente correcta a nuestra vida. Are you here with me?
Yeah.
So it's not going to be deep, it's just going to be challenging. And I want you to understand this. Because I want you to be successful. Quiero que seas exitoso. I want you to forget about your lineage, your natural lineage. I want you to forget about your bloodline, your ancestors, tus tíos, tus primos, the ones that told you that you couldn't. Aquellos que te dijeron que tú no podías.
Yeah.
The word that told you that it's never happened in our family. Aquí hay gente que te ha dicho, en nuestra familia nunca ha habido una persona con dinero. En nuestra familia nunca ha habido una persona que ha graduado. In our family, we've never had people that have money. In our family, we've never had people that graduated. I want you to forget about all those people. Because I want you to change your mind. Because if you change your mind, you'll change your life. Si cambias tu mente, cambias tu vida. Are you here with me? Because listen, we can be stuck for years in places where people said you'll never amount, and you believe them. Because you're looking back at everybody that has failed in their life, in your family, tu familia. We have the tendency to look at the people that have failed. But we never dare to get up and say, you know what, I'm going to be the first one. Thank you, all four of you. Amen. Hallelujah. Like, you really have to get up and say, I'm going to be the first one.
Yep.
In my family, nobody's had money, but I'm going to be the first one.
Yep.
In my family, nobody's had a business, but I'm going to be the first one. En mi familia, nunca había tenido negocio, pero yo voy a ser el primero. En mi familia, nunca había tenido negocio, pero yo voy a ser el primero. I'm going to be the first one. Are you here?
Yeah.
Is there any first one people here?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Look at your neighbor and tell him, I think he's talking to you. And all I want to do is confront you with the truth. Confrontarte con la verdad. Because it will set you free. Te hará libre. And what I want to talk to you about today is something that is going to hurt. It's called diligence. Diligencia. I want to talk to you about diligence. I want you to write this down. Escribe esto. Diligence is the ability to do a little thing a long time till something big happens. Did you hear me?
Amen.
Diligence is the ability to do something a long time till something big happens. La diligencia es la habilidad de hacer algo por mucho tiempo hasta que algo grande suceda. That there, she speaks to somebody right here. When we started this church, I was preaching to like about 8, maybe 15 people, 8 or 15 personas. Like if I had 1,000 people in that room. Como que si tuviera miles de personas. But I kept on doing that diligently till we moved past the 8 and the 17. And it started growing. Y empezó a crecer. Are you here with me?
Amen.
Doing something a long time till something big happens.
Amen.
How do we get a college degree? ¿Cómo agarramos una educación? ¿Lo haces? How do you graduate from school? No, you don't study. You keep on going to school every day for 12 years until you graduate, hasta que gradúas. You do something small for a long time till something big happens. Algo muy pequeño, poquitos pasos, little steps until something big happens. Are you here with me?
Yeah.
Oh, hallelujah. I can tell it's going to get a little bit rough. A drip of water. They're having fun, don't worry. That's okay. They're giving them tires, and when they get home, they'll go straight to bed. Either that, or they just give them chocolate. One of the two. O les acaban de dar mucho chocolate, uno de los dos. So. A small drip of water can change the formation of a rock. Una gotita de agua on a daily basis, diario, cambia la forma de una piedra. I didn't say a tsunami. No dijo tsunami, dijo una gotita de agua. Are you here with me?
Right.
If it drips long enough, it will, hallelujah, change the formation of the rock. If we go outside, si vamos aquí afuera, and you have concrete, tiene cemento. But we go to certain places out here, and then you see grass coming out of nowhere. Sale zacate. Why? Because that grass was pushing a little bit at a time till something broke. Did you hear me? Now, you can go outside and beat that cement outside with your knuckle, and you are going to be bloody. Mm-hmm. Why? Because you're trying to do something real fast and trying to break it, and it will not happen. Because vigilance is pushing. It pushes. And some of you're trying to do things real fast, and God said, no, I want you to just take it slow. Come on, somebody. I'm trying to help you here. That grass, listen, and we grab the grass, and you got, it's very flimsy. And you're like, man, I cannot understand how this broke that. ¿Cómo ese sacatito pudo quebrar el cemento? Because it did something for a long time until something broke. How do you lose 100 pounds?
You work it off.
You do something a little while, a little bit at a time until something big happens. You don't just lose 100 pounds just like that. You do something until something big happens. Are you here with me? Woo. My goodness. This is good. And I haven't even read the word yet. But I just want to let you know what happens when you do something a little while for a long time. The Bible says, pray without
ceasing.
Orar sin cesar. In other words, you keep on praying a long time until something big happens.
Amen.
Hallelujah. In other words, I'm going to do it despite the obstacles. Despite the opposition. No importando el obstáculo, no importando la oposición. Aleluya. Why? Because it burns within me. Quema dentro de mí. Are you hearing me? There's something bigger on the inside of you. You are not who you think you are. You are not who they say you are. There's something inside of you that is burning bigger and is burning more than anything outside of you. Hay algo que está dentro de ti, que está quemando, aleluya, que está quemando. You gotta stay. You say to yourself, there's gotta be something more. There's gotta be something better out there. Tiene que haber algo mejor. But there's something that is burning within you that is not gonna leave you. It's not gonna let you sleep. No te va a dejar dormir. No te va a dejar hacer nada. Why? Because there's something great in you that God put that in you. Dios puso eso dentro de ti. I mean, here with you. And I just want to say this, if you can write this down, you don't have to write it down. But some of you don't have to be delivered from drugs. You don't have to be delivered from addiction. You have to be delivered from the quitting spirit. Muchos de nosotros no tenemos que ser liberados de drogas ni del alcohol. Usted tiene que ser liberado del espíritu de ¿cómo se dice? No lo quiero decir así porque soy muy, muy feo, pero lo voy a decir. Usted tiene el espíritu de rajarse. You have to get rid of the quitting spirit. I can't get rid of that for you. Yo no puedo quitarte ese espíritu. Because some of you, in your lineage, in your family, that's all there's been. Just nothing but quitters. They start something and they quit. Comienzan algo y lo dejan. Comienzan algo y lo dejan. No, you have to be set free from that. Because diligent people continue to do it even if they don't see anything in their life. Si no ven ningún progreso, if they don't see a progress, they continue to get up and they continue to do the same thing. Why? Until something big happens. It might not happen right now and it might not happen tomorrow. But I refuse to quit. Hallelujah. I need some people that are in this place. Si hay alguien aquí en mí, and they say, I refuse to quit. It might quit. I'm not quitting. You know, hallelujah. God has a plan for my life. God has a plan for my children. Hallelujah. And even though it ran in my family, hallelujah, it stops here with me. Aquí se para. It's not going over there. Hallelujah. Are you here with me today? Woo! You need to be set free from the quitting spirit. Tienes que ser libre, aleluya, de ese espíritu que toda tu vida. Everybody's giving up on you. Everybody's quitting left and right. But you gotta get up and say, I'm not quitting. God didn't create no fool. I'm an overcomer. The fool man said, oh, you can leave me if you want to. You can walk away, but I'm still gonna get up. And I'm still gonna do it again tomorrow. And if it doesn't work tomorrow, I'm gonna do it the next day. After something big happens, after the door breaks, after the door opens, I can tell my brother.
you get mad and you try to pray, I'm gonna give you 30 seconds to shout out to God and say, I refuse to quit. Woo! God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. But I'll let me finish this. Let me tell you something. The reason that spirit's been hanging around with you is because you've been hanging around with a lot of quitters. Just because he was your best friend when you were growing up. And he decided to quit. Don't mean you gotta quit. Solamente porque es tu amigo desde niñez y él dejó. Y él se dio por vencido. No quiere decir que tú te vas a dejar por vencido. See, one of the things that you gotta do is you gotta have to go under and change your friends. Oh, not my friends, Pastor. It's something that is not deep. And you might have never known about this, so you might have. But you'll always win if you don't quit.
That's right.
It ain't deep. But it's the truth. Siempre vas a ganar si no te das por vencido. And you will never quit if you'll never win if you always quit. Did you hear me? Siempre vas a perder si siempre estás dándote por vencido. As long as you keep quitting, you'll keep losing. It's getting hot in here. Diligence is an attitude. That probably eliminates certain people already. You mean I gotta change my attitude? Yeah, you gotta change your attitude. It's a very profound thing that is in the scripture. It says your gift will get you in the door.
Yeah, but your attitude.
Yeah, you may be gifted at building houses. It'll get you in the door. But the moment your attitude shows up, I don't care how good you are, you're going out the door. Oh, yeah, I didn't like that right now. Tu don te abre puertas, pero tu carácter te saca.
Yes.
See, your gift will get you in the room, but your attitude will kick you out.
Yes.
You need to tweet that one. Why do they keep on firing me if I'm the best worker? It's because your attitude.
Yes.
Diligence is an attitude. Diligence is an attitude where goals have been set. Strategies, planes, estrategias han sido puestas. Are you here with me?
Amen.
And you set the course, you will put a plan, and then after you do that, there's a price that has to be paid.
Amen.
Hay un precio que se tiene que pagar para obtener la recompensa, to receive the reward. Meaning, I used to hang around with you, but now I can't hang around with you no more. Why? Because now I have to be more disciplined. This is good stuff. You have to pray the price. Diligence. Diligence is what takes you between starting and finishing. La diligencia te lleva al comenzar y también a terminar. Are you here with me? Diligence, listen, catch this. Diligence is an attitude that companies look for. I don't care if you don't know the business, but if you're diligent, they're gonna hire you. Because they can train you. This diligence is something you can't train. It's something that's already in you. Ya está dentro de ti. Are you here with me? So I want to encourage you today, church. Change your attitude. Diligence is what you need in your business.
Amen.
Tu negocio. Pastor Rowling can tell you,
His first jobs were maybe $500, $1,000. But he kept on doing the $500, the $1,000 till something big happened.
Yes, amen.
Now, he doesn't accept jobs that are $550 and $1,000. Why? Because the business grew. Something big happened. Algo sucedió, algo grande. You do the little things a long time till something big happens. Are you here with me?
Amen.
Hallelujah. Diligence is what the leaders need. Los líderes necesitan, hermano, aleluya, esa diligencia. Because if you don't have diligence, catch this, because this is very important. If you don't have diligence, you'll never be a leader. You'll always be a follower. See, I'm going to deliver you from the spirit of follower. Because you're always a follower is always waiting on somebody else.
Yeah, that's right.
Un seguidor. Te vamos a liberar del espíritu de seguidor.
Yeah.
I'm not talking about following Jesus. We have to follow Jesus. Tenemos que seguir a Jesús. That's not what I'm talking about.
Amen.
But what I'm talking about is that if you are a follower, you're always dependent on somebody else.
Yes.
Si eres un seguidor, estás dependiendo de alguien más. God never told you to depend on somebody else. God told you to depend on Him. God told you to go into all the world and preach the gospel. Dios te dijo a ti que fueras a todo el mundo y predicaras el evangelio. God told you to pray for the sick. Dios te dijo a ti que oraras por el enfermo. God told you to start that business. Dios te dijo a ti que comenzaras tu ese negocio. Stop waiting on people, aleluya, because they are not going to get you to where God wants you to go. You need to get up and say, you know what? I refuse to be a follower. I ain't following nobody else. I'm going to make my own steps because He's guiding my steps. He's leading my steps. Dios está guiando mis pasos, aleluya. So I'm going to become my own boss.
Go set your propio pastor.
Look at your neighbor and tell him, he read the scripture. But this is stuff that's already, it's in the Bible, church. We have to get you free from that. Proverbs chapter 1, verse 1. We're going to read 1 through 5. Read. Amen. Proverbios, capítulo 1, del 1 al 5. If you don't have a Bible, they'll put it up there on the screen. It says the Proverbs of Solomon, son of David, king of Israel. Proverbios de Salomón, hijo de David, rey de Israel. Verse 2, versículo 2. For attaining wisdom and discipline, for understanding words of insight. Dice, para adquirir sabiduría y disciplina, para discernir palabras de inteligencia. Verse 3, for acquiring a disciplined and prudent life, doing what is right and just not fair. Dice, para recibir la corrección que dan la prudencia, la rectitud, la justicia y la equidad. Verse 4, for giving prudence to the simple, knowledge and discretion to the young, para infundir sagacidad en los inexpertos, conocimiento y discernimiento a los jóvenes. Verse 5. Let the wise listen and add to their learning, and let the discerning get guidance. Dice, escucha el sabio y aumentará su saber. Reciba dirección el entendido. Glory be to God. Let me give you this. You cannot increase your life if you do not increase your learning. Let me say that again. You cannot increase your life if you do not increase your learning. Usted no puede aumentar su vida si no aumenta su entendimiento. You cannot rise above the level of your learning. Did you hear me? You cannot rise above. Usted no puede ir más arriba del nivel de su entendimiento. You cannot outlive your level of wisdom. Usted no puede sobrevivir su nivel de sabiduría. Are you here with me? You have to increase. You have to increase the knowledge. You have to increase the wisdom. You have to increase the knowledge and wisdom in your marriage. En tu matrimonio necesitas la sabiduría, necesitas el entendimiento. Are you here with me? You need wisdom. You need knowledge to train up a child. Yeah. Necesitamos sabiduría, entendimiento, de hermano, para entrenar a nuestros hijos. Are you here with me?
Hallelujah.
So when you increase, listen, you can't be stretched more than what you know.
That's right.
Usted no puede ser rastirado más de lo que usted sabe. ¿Está aquí conmigo?
Amen.
You can only be stretched as far as you know.
Right.
The more you know, the more you stretch.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Look at your neighbor, tell him it's time to stretch.
It's time to stretch.
Verse 5, versículo 5, it says, a man of understanding will attain wise counsel.
Yeah.
Un hombre de entendimiento, dice, un hombre de entendimiento va a recibir, aleluya, consejería sabia. Not just any counsel, but wise counsel. No cualquier sabiduría. So, some of you, this is very important. I believe this is going to set you free right here. Mm. Some of you need to reevaluate who you're listening to.
That's right.
Yeah. I'm going to float out there just for a little while. This is good stuff.
Right.
Hay algunos de nosotros que tenemos que reevaluar a quién le estamos escuchando.
Yeah.
If you are going to somebody for marriage counseling, you have better make sure that their marriage is good. Si tú necesitas consejería matrimonial, vale más que estés seguro que con quien vas a ir a recibir consejería, el matrimonio de ellos sucedió. If you are going to somebody for counseling with your children, you have better make sure that their children are right. See, your friend don't know anything about counseling. So he shouldn't know anything about... Come on, somebody. It's because he might be a BFF. Or she might be a BFF. You'll be a BFF. Their marriage is just as messed up as yours. Your BFF don't know what to do. Your BFF is going to tell you to leave them. Es que mi amigo, mi amiga, tiene que saber todo. No, no tiene que saber todo, porque tu amiga, el matrimonio de tu amiga se está quebrantando. ¿Cómo, qué consejo te va a dejar? Come on. I told you it was getting in there. I'm going to jump in there with both feet. Because if it's working for them, listen, the person that lost 100 pounds, you might not like them. But if you're wanting to lose some weight, you better make sure you go talk to them and tell them, hey, what you do? I don't like you, but tell me how you lost the weight, because I need to lose weight myself. Come on, somebody. You might not like the person, but if they're successful, you better go over there because they know something you don't know. Oh, my goodness. La persona que perdió 100 libras. Aunque no te guste, no te quiere, aunque lo odies, vale más que le preguntes cómo los perdió si tú quieres perder peso. Because you didn't wake up one day and say, man, I lost 100 pounds. I weigh 300, I weigh 200 today. Woo! They didn't have the lose weight anointing. No, they did something a little while, a long time, till something big happens. Are you here with me? This is good stuff, church. I don't even know if I'm finished this. Strongly help you. Is that okay?
Yes.
Because this stuff that you're going to be able to teach your children, if you don't want your kids to fail, because you said a while ago that everything stopped with you, that from this day forth, your generation coming is going to be better than you. But if you don't know, if you can't increase in learning, that's why I said you got to open up not just your natural ears, but you have to open up your spiritual ears to be able to hear. Para que puedas escuchar, abre tus oídos espirituales. Amen. Now don't go out of here. And then they ask you what you learned. You're like, I don't know. He was just babbling up there. Don't do that. Look at your neighbor and say, don't do that. Verse 6, versículo 6. For understanding proverbs and parables, the sayings and the riddles of the wise. Dice, para entender, para discernir el proverbio y la parábola, los dichos de los sabios y sus enigmas. Número 7. The fear of the Lord is the beginning of knowledge. Let me read that again. The fear of the Lord is the beginning of knowledge. El temor del Señor es el principio del conocimiento o la sabiduría.
Amén, aleluya.
Gracias. But fools. You may be talking to me there, Pastor. But fools despise wisdom and discipline.
Yeah, that's right.
Oh, aleluya. Pero el necio desprecian la sabiduría y la disciplina. My goodness. How many fools you know? You call a lot of people, hey, what's up, fool? You telling them, bro, you ain't got no wisdom, no ounce of wisdom in you. No tienes ninguna sabiduría. Dígale, ¿qué pasó, decir? See, we don't know that. We don't know that, but we speak that into our children's life. No sabemos, pero lo hablamos a nuestros hijos, a la vida de ellos. Este niño anda bien necio. Come on. The baby's all crying, está llorando porque es niño, es, he's a baby. He's going to cry, he's going to run, he's going to fall, he's going to do all this thing. Y decimos, anda bien necio. What you're saying is that this baby has no ounce of wisdom in it. Ay, ¿por qué salió tan torpe mi hijo? You told him. ¿Por qué salió tan necio mi hijo? Why did my child acting out like a fool? Because you spoke that over his life when he was young. And all he knows is what you told him. You better be careful what you say in front of your kids. Because they don't lie. Tus hijos no mienten. There's times that we have a conversation with the children's ministry teachers. And they say, Pastor, guess what the kids said? Pastor, ¿sabe qué nos dijeron los niños? My mom and my dad had a big old argument before they came to church. And right before they stepped in, they're holding hands, kissing each other like. What you doing? You're confusing your children. Estás confundiendo tus hijos. Are you here with me? Let me tell you something. God designed, this is very powerful. God designed for somebody else to impart into your life. Dios lo diseñó para que alguien más imparta tu vida. Are you here with me? God has placed people. God has placed this ministry here to impart into your life. Thank you, all three of you. Dios ha puesto este ministerio aquí para impartir sabiduría sobre tu vida. And what I'm telling you today will bring you great blessing, but if you don't receive it, it'll bring you great curses. Te voy a traer, aleluya, te va a traer bendición o te va a traer maldición. It's up to you. Are you hearing me? It's very important that we understand. Es muy importante, mi hermano, entender eso. If you see it happening in their life, they must be doing something different. Quizás ellos están haciendo algo diferente. Are you hearing me? But here is the problem. Here lies the problem. This is a problem of your mind. The problem is this. We don't want to listen to nobody. El problema que tenemos es que no le queremos hacer caso a nadie. We don't want nobody to tell us what to do, when to do it, and how to do it. No queremos que nadie nos diga cómo hacerlo, cuándo hacerlo. Listen. There's a word I'm praying to the Lord that God helps me with this word. Every time we talk to people and we tell them what they're supposed to do, cada vez que hablamos con gente, my wife and I, probably you guys have had this experience too. This is what they say. I know. Hablamos con alguien que esté teniendo problemas y le decimos un consejo, y ¿sabe qué dice?
Yo sé.
Well, if you know, why you coming here for counseling? ¿Para qué vienes para sabiduría si ya conoces? Look, sister, you ain't doing right. So,
yeah, I know.
Pastor, I'm having trouble with my marriage because, well, have you tried? Yeah, I know how to do that. The Lord has to deliver you from the I know spirit. Because the Bible says, woe to those who know how to do good and don't do. You can't come, don't come and waste my time if you already know. No vengas a gastar mi tiempo si ya sabes. I know it's hard. I'm just massaging the word. I'm trying to get it in there real quick. I know. Deliver them, Father God, in the name of Jesus. We don't want to listen to nobody. We don't want to listen to our parents. No queremos hacerle caso a nuestros padres, a nuestra madre. We don't want to listen to the pastor. We don't want to listen to the teacher. I hate it when you come and ask me for counseling and I give you and I take my time to give you advice or my wife, and then you go to them and ask them the same question because you want them to tell you something different than we told you. La gente viene y nos pide nosotros consejo. Le damos consejo y no les gustó. Ah, pero van a ir con el pastor Rolando y Diana para que le den consejo. Now, if they don't like their counsel, they're going to go to Pastor García. Van a ir a la pastora García. Y luego cuando llegan con la pastora García, dice, es que el pastor fulano, pues si el pastor fulano te dijo, ¿para qué me vienes a decir a mí? Why are you telling me if you already went to Pastor so-and-so and then the other pastor, and everybody's telling you the same thing? Te están diciendo lo mismo. I'm not going to tell you something different. I'm going to tell you what you need to do. Now, if you don't want to do it, that's not up to any pastor. That's up to you and your stubbornness. But I know. Pastor, I wasn't coming for this today. No, but you're going to get it. You're going to get this today. Because you need to be set free. You cannot have your children doing the same thing you're doing. If you're getting delivered from the I know spirit, your children got to be delivered from the I know spirit, because your children know the I know spirit, because all they hear you say is, I know, I know, I know. Well, if you know, stop doing it.
Amen.
You know you got to stop going to that bar. I know. And then you post selfies. Ya no puedes ir a esas cantinas. No, yo sé, pastor, yo sé. Y los siguientes días están tomando fotos ahí enfrente de la... Querida, si ya sabes, dice Pipo, si ya sabes cómo me pongo, ¿para qué me invitas? ¿Por qué no me invitas? Some of you, listen. And I'm going to be real honest with you. Some of you, y'all don't even have time to do overs. Let me let that one flow. Let me let you think about it. I'll just do it over. No, you don't have time to do overs. You better get it right now. Pero más que lo hagas bien ahorita, porque no hay tiempo de hacerlo otra vez mañana. No, there's no time. You're getting old. Te estás envejeciendo, aleluya. No, pues comienza otra vez de nuevo. No, no, comienza. Comiénzale ahorita, right now. Don't move. No time. Look at you, never time. You got time for the overs. You better get it right, and you better get it right now.
Right.
If she ain't for you, you better leave her. If he ain't for you, you ain't got time for.
Amen.
You better get it right now.
No. Amen. Just so watch my babies in the
back. Look at you, never time. He hurting me. That hurts. Es como poniéndole alcohol a una herida. It's like putting alcohol in a cut. Or you got, but it's going to get better. It'll take all the infection off of you. Amen? Diligence. Very important. Very simple. I'm not going real deep. I just want to challenge you. I want to give you a word that is going to help you. Amen? I don't want you to go around the same circle. Amen? We break every spirit of cycle in your life. If your family, if your mama and their mama and their mama, mama and their mama, mama, mama and auntie and brother and sister and all of them went through that cycle, you better cut it off in your life. Hallelujah. And you better make sure you cut it off in your children's life because they ain't getting what they got. Hallelujah. I refuse to allow my kids to receive what my ancestors got. Si mi tío, mi tío, mi primo, mi abuela, mi tatarabuela, mi tatarabuela tenía esto, mi familia, mis hijos no lo van a tener. No, I refuse. I break that cycle right now. I break the cycle of poverty up in my life. I break the cycle of the quitting spirit right now in my life. I refuse to walk one more step, hallelujah, with that same kind of attitude. Con esa misma actitud, ya no voy a dar un paso. Why? Because his steps are ordered. My steps are ordered by him, I'm sorry. Are you here with me? Y'all making me sweat up in here. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. It's hot in here. Amen. Amen. It's hot in here. Anyway.
Really?
Woo! Oh, for real. It's hot in here, guys. Woo! Y'all better be glad I'm bringing another shower. I'm going to take this one off. Proverbs 6:6. 6:6, capítulo 6, versículo 6, Proverbs. We're still in Proverbs. This stuff is good. Hallelujah. 6:6. It says, go to the ant, you sluggard. That's a harsh word right there. Dice, anda, perezoso, fíjate en la hormiga. You sluggard. That's what I'm gonna tell people next time they don't want to do nothing. You sluggard. It says, consider its ways and be wise. Dice, considera sus caminos y sé sabio. It has no commander, no captain, no overseer, or ruler. Dice, no tiene quien la mande, ni quien la vigile, ni la gobierne. My God. He didn't say, look at the giraffe. He didn't say, look at the cheetah or the lion. He looked all the way down where all the muddy, that little pile of mud you have in your house, the one that you hate. The one you want to try to get rid of every summer. You get rid of that one, they're coming out over there. Come on, right? He said, look at the ant. The smallest one. The más pequeña. Mira la hormiga. Why? Because we can learn a lot from an ant. Podemos aprender mucho de la hormiga. Hallelujah. Are you hearing me? I'm just reading the word. Verse 8. Yet it stores, look at the end. It doesn't have an overseer or ruler. It says, yet it stores its provision in summer and gathers its food at harvest. Dice, con todo, en el verano almacena provisiones y durante la cosecha recoge alimentos. How long will you lie there, you slug? I'm just reading the word. That's what it says, right? What does it say? How long will you slumber? How long will you slumber? It says, when will you get up from your sleep? ¿Cuándo te levantarás del sueño? A little sleep, a little sueño. A little folding of the hands to rest. Dice, un corto sueño, una breve siesta, un pequeño descanso cruzado de brazos. This is verse 11, el versículo 12. And poverty will come on you like a bandit, and scarcity like an armed man. Dice, y te asaltará la pobreza como un bandido, y la escasez como un hombre armado. Wow. This stuff. The people that procrastinate, la gente que ¿cómo se dice procrastinate? Procrastinar. People that say, mañana lo hago, I'll do it tomorrow.
I know.
All of a sudden you got gray hairs. De repente te salieron las canas. Because time went by so fast. And you never did anything, and you never amounted to anything. Lucas is another. Why? Because you said, I'll do it tomorrow. I want to deliver some people from the tomorrow spirit.
Yes.
Queremos liberar a la gente del espíritu del mañana. Because the Bible says that now faith. La Biblia dice que la fe ahora es pues la fe ahora. Not tomorrow, now. You need the now kind of faith today.
Hallelujah.
Look at somebody say, now. Verse 7 says, the ant has no captain. La hormiga no tiene capitán. Doesn't have an overseer or a ruler. No tiene alguien que la gobierne. But yet, it's diligent. Es diligente. Diligent people, catch this, is very important. Diligent people are self-motivators. La gente diligente es gente que se motiva solo o sola. Can I just tell you something real quick? Let them know. You can keep them knocking, but you can't come in. It is very hard for me to stay in a relationship with you if I have to encourage you 24/7, 365. You see how the claps and amens como que se fueron? Es muy duro que yo me mantenga en una relación contigo si tengo que estarte animando 24 horas al día, los 365 días, whatever I'm doing. It is very hard for me to stay in a relationship. If I see you, I know already I gotta encourage you. Que cada vez que te miro, ya te tengo que animar porque ya vine otra vez con la cara baja. But diligent people are self-motivators. La gente diligente es gente, mi hermano, que se motiva solo. Are you here with me? Can I tell you something? If I have to encourage you to come to church, you might as well not come, because you probably didn't want to be here in the first place.
Amen.
Let that one just come in. Si tengo que animarte todos los días a venir a la iglesia, no vengas, porque quizás no quieres estar aquí. If I have to encourage you to worship, don't worship, because you probably don't want to do it anyway. We come in here every Wednesday and every Sunday and tell you to lift your hands. And we tell you to worship. And we tell you to come to the altar. And we tell you to do that. You probably don't want to do it, so we're probably just wasting our time trying to tell you to do something that you don't want to do.
That's right.
Amen. Pastor, the other church, they didn't preach like you preach. Si tengo que animarte a adorar, no adores. Probablemente no quieres adorar. But the people that worship are people that know that it had nothing to do with me or my strength, but it had to do with everything that he did. La gente que viene a adorar sabe que no está en ellos ni la fuerza de ellos, sino que fue él el que hizo todo. It is by him, it is through him, and it is for him. Es para él, es de él, y él hizo todo. He got me through this thing. Listen, in my own strength, I couldn't get up here. Yo no podía venir aquí con mi propio. It was God who did it. Dios lo hizo. It is because of God. I could have gave up. I could have, listen, I could have folded this week. I could have, listen, you would have came here today and those doors would have been closed. Esas puertas iban a estar cerradas esta semana, aleluya, si hubiera dicho yo, ¿ya para qué? Why? But no, you know what? He gave me the desire. I remember what he did for me in the cross. And what he did for me in the cross does not compare to the hell that I've been through on this earth. He's been through far more than me. He doesn't deserve me to treat him like that. Él no merece que yo lo trate de esa manera. Él ha pasado por tanto más de lo que yo. Yo sí he pasado por un infierno. But my God, aleluya, Jesus got whipped. Jesus got spit, Jesus got punched, Jesus got stabbed, Jesus did all this, but yet he still said, hang me on that cross, because I'm not going to let my child hang on that cross. I'm going to stand here for him, hallelujah, and he deserves to be worshipped, and he deserves to be honored, and if you don't want to do it, that's fine, but don't get in my way, because I know the price that he paid. I know that I couldn't do it on my own. I know that I couldn't get out, hallelujah, but he got me out. He set me free. He set me out. He restored my life. He restored my family. He restored my children. I got what I got because of him. I don't get it from you. I don't get it from nobody. You need to do for me what he did for me. He is worthy to be praised. Somebody shout to God right now and say you are worthy. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah! You better get out of my way. You don't want to worship. Get out of my way. Get out of my way. I'm about to stand to the face. I can run. I didn't know what to do this week. But God lifted me up.
Hallelujah.
God, my God. Cayó el micrófono, I'm sorry. Estoy hablando de comprar otro, no se preocupe. I know. Dígale, I know, people, dígale, I know. If I have to, if I have to pat you on the back every time you do something, then you're looking for the approval of men.
And not of God.
Si tengo que venir a palmearte la espalda cada vez que haces un trabajo, entonces estás buscando la aprobación del hombre y no de Dios. If I have the right to thank you every time you do something for me. Si tengo que regarte notitas ahí y decirte gracias, gracias porque lo hice. Estás buscando la aprobación del hombre y no de Dios. Are you here with me? You should be looking for the approval of man. Because God already approved you.
Yeah.
Did you hear me?
Yeah.
If you're going to do it, do it for him.
Yeah.
Or don't do it at all. Si lo vas a hacer, hazlo por Dios, o no lo hagas.
Hallelujah.
You're going to do it because you have love for God. Lo vas a hacer porque tienes el amor de Dios.
Yes.
I don't have to motivate you. No tengo que motivar. Tú hazlo. Because God gave me the will.
Yeah.
Dios te dio la voluntad. To do.
Yeah.
Para hacer. Are you hearing me? Hallelujah. If you look at somebody and say, I'm going to motivate myself.
I'm
going to motivate myself. I'm a motivate myself. If you don't motivate me, that's okay. That's all right, sister. If you don't need to motivate, I can look at myself in the mirror. Yo me miro en el espejo and say, you can do it, brother. You can do it. Today is your day. This is the day that oh, yes, you need to get up and look in the mirror. You need to clean that mirror, by the way, because it's a little bit dusty, hallelujah. Because you ain't looked in it for a while already. But you need to clean it up and start looking in that mirror and say, I can do it. I came this far. Yo he venido tan lejos para llegar al lugar de Dios que es para mí, hallelujah. Sometimes you just gotta look, because there's not gonna be nobody there, hallelujah, to motivate you. So you gotta look at yourself and say, you can do it. You can. Nobody believed in you, but look at where you are now. Look at the road. Mira, la, mira el camino. You were over there, but now you're over here. Estabas allá. Y ahora, woo, good job. Hallelujah. Somebody, you gotta pat yourself on the back and say, you're doing a good job, brother. You're doing a good job, sister. Listen, you know what? I'm not even gonna put makeup on today, because I'm just that good. Hallelujah. Come on, buddy. Although some of you might need a little bit of makeup, but that's all right. I don't have to put a full makeup on. You have to develop that I want it, that I'm going to do it, sir. Tienes que empezar a desarrollar ese espíritu de que tú lo vas a hacer. Are you hearing me? And when you start doing it, I'm not going to promise you that you're going to have everybody on your back. As a matter of fact, I'm going to tell you everything's going to come against you. When you decide to get up and do something right, all hell is going to come against you. Todos se van a venir en contra de ti cuando te levantes a hacer bien. My question to you is that when all the hell raises up and all the opposition, are you still going to motivate yourself? When you look at disappointment in front of you, when you look at the naysayers in front of you, cuando miras a todos aquellos que no creen en ti, are you going to get up and say, you know what, I'm still going to do it? Oh, listen, mom, because I don't believe that. You have got to get up and say, you know what, I'm going to be somebody.
Right.
Yo voy a ser algo. You can look back and say, you know what, my dad didn't amount to nothing, my mom didn't amount to nothing, they didn't amount to nothing, but it's suffering. I'm just here for you. I'm going to be somebody. I'm going to make somebody myself. It might not like me, and that's okay. I don't need a pat on the back. I know who's got my back. You're sitting stuck with me. I know who called me. By the way, you didn't call me. You didn't choose me. You did not anoint me. You did not even help me. We will have critics.
Yes, we will.
Vamos a tener gente que nos va a criticar. And by the way, pastor will not be there to motivate you. When the quitters, or when the critics are there. Cuando los críticos están ahí, que tienen que van a criticar, el pastor no va a estar ahí. So somehow, somewhere, you're going to have to find a way to get up and say, that's okay. You can talk about me all you want. Sticks and stones, break my bones, but your words will not have an impact in my life. Tus palabras no van a tener, aleluya, un impacto. Are you here with me? Is anybody in here? There's just nothing. Some of you, you're still up, and people didn't believe you'll ever get up out of that mess. People look at you and say, man, I don't think that guy's going to get up from that anymore. And here you are, you're walking, you're driving a new car, you're in a new house, you're making more money than before, and they're like, how did he do that? How did he manage to get up out of that one? He said, well, I didn't get up, he got me up. See, you don't have to. You know how you can silence your critics? ¿Usted sabe cómo puede silenciar a los críticos? Let me tell you, this is a key right here for you. If you ever want to silence your critics, be successful. Success will always silence your critics. El éxito siempre va a silenciar a los críticos. You don't have to fight them. You don't have to stay there and argue. No tienes que pelearles. All you got to do is tell them, God bless you. Dios te bendiga. Sometimes I'm praying for you. And God will bless you. Dios te bendiga. Y no mandes preguntas. And you just walk away.
Yeah.
And then succeed.
Amen.
If the stuff that's in you burns more than what's outside of you, then you keep on walking. Si lo que está dentro de ti quema más de lo que está fuera de ti, sigue caminando. If you're always looking for outside acceptance, you'll never get nowhere. Si usted está dependiendo de la gente de afuera de usted, usted nunca va a llegar a ser nadie. By the way, Satan knows what you have inside of you. Satanás sabe lo que él ha puesto dentro, lo que Dios ha puesto dentro de ti. Are you here with me?
Amen.
Noah built an ark.
Amen.
120 years, 120 años, Noah. It's gonna rain. La gente venía, the critics. What are you doing? Man, you look dumb. I mean, that's muy ridículo. There hasn't rained here. No ha llovido aquí. It's gonna rain. His message never changed. How does it work for somebody? Es una palabra para alguien. His message never changed. The critics never changed his message. He said, it's not raining. Oh, but it's going to rain. See, the thing is that the naysayers have came in and changed your message.
There you go.
Yo quiero, cuando vaya a la casa, digo, ya sé lo que dijo Pastor con él. It's going to rain. Then all of a sudden, 120 years, rain.
Yeah.
Yo, yo. And only 8 people got saved.
Yes.
And Noah started writing, and what the people thought never would happen. Mm-hmm. Did you hear that? Did you get that?
Amen, brother.
Noah started writing, and what the people said never would happen. Noah empezó a navegar en lo que la gente le había dicho que nunca iba a suceder. Now they're out there knocking the door. Noah! Glory, flotando, ¿verdad? Noé, abre la puerta, Noé. You keep on knocking. I told you for 120 years that I'm going to be successful. I told them I own my own business. I mean, if you didn't believe me, you me creíste. Now you want to come and ask me for a loan. Ahora me quieres pedir un préstamo, aleluya. Listen, I told you I'm going to be somebody. I told them I have my own house. I told them I have my own car. I told them I have my own business. Successful business. Un negocio exitoso. Voy a tener mi propia casa. Voy a tener mi propio carro. Aleluya. Pero ahora como ya lo tengo, me vienes a pedir a mí. Because you're still stuck in that old mentality. Todavía estás atorado en esa mentalidad. Now you're floating around wanting me to open up the door. What took me 120 years to build. Aleluya. Now you just want to come in and wander. Oh, no, sir. You better go to the back of the line. Para que te vayas para allá. Because it took me some time to build what God said to continue to feel in the midst of opposition, in the midst of the critics, and then in the opinion of the opposition, dice Dios que sigue, and Noah kept on building and hammering, y seguía martillando la madera. Ay, no es que menso que no con esto que no es. Esta bien seguía. God bless you, but it's going to rain. Hallelujah. Dios te bendiga, pero va a llover. Hallelujah. Listen, the rain is coming. Your blessing is coming. Your breakthrough is coming. You just keep on hammering. You keep on building. And you keep on being successful. Sigue siendo exitoso. Porque la lluvia viene. My God. Somebody is going to knock at your door. Wanting to get. Hallelujah. What they said you never would have done. My God. My God. Hallelujah. My God. Woo! Hallelujah. Look at your neighbor. Tell him I love you, but I can't encourage you every day. Te amo, pero no te puedo estar animando cada día. Hallelujah. My God. Some of you. Ya veo camino. I'm sorry. This is just too good. Can I tell you something? Some of you need to be your own cheerleader. Algunos de ustedes van a tener que ser su propio porrista. You better go get you a cheerleading outfit with pom poms and everything. Every time you get a brace, you better go put it on and do flips and cartwheels and all that and start doing like the P and give me a P and give me a this and give me that, whatever it is. But listen, there ain't gonna be nobody there but you. But it's all right, hallelujah, because you are what God said you were going. Hallelujah. Bible says that all things work together for good. Todas las cosas nos ayudan para bien. Es lo que Dios dice en la Biblia, ¿verdad que sí? God gives us the will. Dios nos da la voluntad para hacer. Ya voy a terminar. Whatever the naysayers are doing, don't let them break your will.
Right. Yeah.
Oh, God, I feel that's a word for somebody. Amen. Cualquier cosa que la gente que te ha criticado, te ha dicho, no dejes que eso quiebre tu voluntad, la voluntad que Dios ha puesto.
Amen.
Because God put the will in you. Dios puso la voluntad dentro de ti. Are you hearing me? And the Bible says that God ordered your steps. Dios ordenó tus pasos. Can I just give you this and go home? I know some of you are hungry right now. Do you know that God has ordered your yeses? But he has also ordered your noes. Dios ordenó tus pasos. Dios ha ordenado todos tus sís. And I know you don't like to hear this because you always want a yes. But God has also ordered your noes. My God. Hallelujah. Are you hearing me?
Hallelujah.
And when they tell you no, you give up. And you say, well, I'm not going to do it no more because they told me no. But you have to understand that God has ordered my steps.
That's right,
man. Let me tell you something. His no is God's yes.
Amen. That's right.
Amen.
Did you get it? No lo agarraron, ¿verdad? ¿Otra vez? El no de él. In other words, if you go to a job and they tell you no, don't get mad. Because that's God's yes. What do you mean, Pastor? I don't understand. You already got me all confused. No. The reason they told you no is because God said, I don't want that job for you. I got a better one over here, but I got to make them say no. So that way you can turn around and go to the one. Did you hear me? So, because God will turn it around for my good. If that job's for me, it's for my good. If that job's not for me, it's for my good. Si ese trabajo es para mí, es para mi bien. Y si ese trabajo no es para mí, es para mi bien. If that girl is for me, it's for my good. And if that girl is not for me, it's for my good. Mírate la mosca, ahí está la mosca ahí. If they deny you the loan, it was for your good. And if they gave it to you, it was for your good. Come on, church, get it. It is God's best because everything will work out for your good. His yes means yes, and their no means also his yes. God is trying to take you from something, from you to get into something that he never designed for you to get. Dios está tratando de salvarte que tú entres en algo que nunca diseñó que tú entras.
Amen.
Are you here with me?
Amen.
Oh, my goodness. It's very important that we understand this. I want to tell you this. Ya con este ahora sí es cierto, vamos a encargarnos. God will use the enemy. For your
good.
Dios usa el enemigo para tu bien. Listen, the Bible says that if the religious people knew what they were doing when they were crucifying Jesus, they would have never done it. They killed one man and then multiplied to millions of Christians. Did you hear me?
Amen.
Mataron a Jesús y se multiplicó en millones. Ahora hay millones de cristianos. Let me just give you this so you can take it home with you as a side dish. Un panecito. Una empanadita. Esa es de las que hace usted. Como que me está dando un dedito por ahí para nada. Let me tell you, let me give you this, and I'll send you for real, I'll send you for this. Listen, if your enemies would know what they're doing to you,
only you, that's right.
They would already stop messing with you. Si tus enemigos supieran lo que están haciendo, cuando vienen, when they're coming against you, if they knew that they're not hurting you, they're helping you.
Amen.
There was stuff missing. The more they come with you, the more they help you.
That's right.
That's
true.
Yeah. If they only knew. You close the door that way you thought it was in. God said, no, that door was meant to be closed. I just used you to close it. So that way I can get God's soul here to go over here. Because this is a glory. Because we're stoked. I mean, we'll go and apply again. For real, we'll go in the pray again. No, this is for me. God said, I'm trying to close this door because I got a bigger one over here. And I have to allow the enemy to do all this. And ya va el diablo como menso. I got him. They said, no, you don't got him. I used you. A puppet. Como un ventrilo, ¿verdad? Como un muñeco. Now he's got to go look somewhere. God said, no, it's because I got a door open over there. He's going up. Doing a little thing all the time until something big happens.
Amen.
Come to church. Every day. Until something big happens.
That's right.
Pastor, how long am I supposed to worship? Until something happens. Pastor, how long am I supposed to pray? Until something happens.
Yes.
Right. Okay, I listen to that.
Amen.
I'm not going to stop praying until it happens.
Amen.
I need you to look at somebody and say, you know what? Success is inevitable in my life. That's what it is. Inevitable. El éxito es inevitable en mi vida. In other words, listen, whether you like it or not, I'm going to be successful. Whether you like it or not, I'm getting up again. Lo voy a levantar una vez más. Te guste o no te guste, me voy a levantar aquí. Whether you like it or not, I'm going to be successful with your blessing or you don't bless me. I'm still going to be successful. My success does not depend on you. It depends on me. Mi éxito no viene de ti. Mi deseo es que sea prosperado.
Amen.
Todas estas cosas. My desire is for you to prosper in all these things. Even as your soul.
Yeah.
Aún como tú prosperas, tu alma.
Amen.
My God. Woo. My prayer is that you leave this place today smarter than you came. I pray that you use some of this stuff. Some of you guys, you need to go and you need to go retweet this, put it on Facebook, send it to somebody who needs it. Because there's a lot of people that we come in contact with them. Yeah. These little listen, you just gotta continue to keep getting up. Levántate, sigue levantando hasta diez. Do you understand how long? Just keep on getting up.
Yeah.
How long? Until something breaks. Hasta que algo quiere. I want you to lift up your hands. I want you to just declare this for me. Declare this for me, por favor. I want you to declare, I will no longer. Diga yo ya no. I will not procrastinate anymore. Ya no voy a procrastinar. I'm going to be diligent in what I do. Voy a ser diligente en lo que hago. I'm going to be successful. And what I do. With my better half or without my better half. Con mi media naranja o sin mi media naranja. Con mi esposo o sin mi esposa. With my wife or without my wife. Because success runs in my bloodline. Porque el éxito corre en mi vida. I am who God says I am. Yo soy quien Dios dice que soy. I will have what God says I have. Come on, declare that. I will have what God says I have. Yo soy quien Dios dice que soy. Yo voy a tener lo que Dios dice que voy a tener. From this day forth, desde este día adelante, I am a diligent person. Soy una persona de diligencia. I'm going to seek God until something big happens. Voy a buscar a Dios hasta que algo grande suceda.
That's the word. Amen. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Glory.
And from this day forth,